Okay, hello everyone. Let's start our story, chapter 4. But first, let's revise. We said that the title of our story is Robinson Crusoe. The title of our story is Robinson Crusoe, and this is the cover of your story. And this is Robinson Crusoe. And we said first that when Robinson was 18 years old, he wanted to leave the home. And he wanted to sail. What's the meaning of sail? We said sail means to travel by sea. Sail means to travel by sea. He wanted to travel by sea and see new places and new countries and to have new friends. And he thought that it was a very adventure. He will see many wonderful adventures. But his father refused. He said, no, you cannot leave this house. If you leave this house and live alone, you will have a very sad and bad life. So he went to his mom, and we said that he asked his mom to make his father understand his ideas. But his father refused. He said that you think that it will be an adventure, but it will be very dangerous. Did he listen to his father's words? No, he didn't listen to his father's words, and he left his house. And then what happened to him? The first ship he was on sank by a storm, and he sailed by another ship, and a pirate took this ship, and he became a slave. What's meaning of slave? We said slave means a servant. Slave means a servant but without money. You serve someone but you didn't take any money. So he didn't have any luck at sea. And he said, oh, I didn't listen to my father's words, and this is why this happened to me. So again, the first ship sank in a storm, and the other ship, a bad pirate, took the other ship and became a slave. Then he ran away from this bad pirate, and a good captain from Portugal took him to Brazil. And what did he do in Brazil? Who remember? We said it last time. Yes, he bought land and he made money in Brazil. And then his friends will tell him, oh, let's go to Guinea to find slaves and sell them and get money. He will not stay in Brazil forever. He traveled again. And then while he was traveling, his ship sank in a storm again. So his ship sank in a storm again, and he was the only one to live. All the men on the ship sank. And he became alone on an island. He became alone on an island. Okay, how did he live on this island? Who remember? We said that at the first night, he slept on a tree because he was afraid of wild animals. Because he was afraid of wild animals. So he slept on the tree. Then in the early morning, he went to the broken ship, to his ship, and he took its sail. This is the sail. He took the sail of the ship and make a tent. So again, he took the sail. This is the sail of the broken ship and make a tent to live in. And then he made raft. He made a raft from the broken pieces of the ship. Why did he make this raft? To help him, this raft will help him to move from the island to the ship to get his things. So again, he made a raft to help him move from the ship to the island. Every morning he goes to the ship and bring things from this ship and put it on the island. Like what? Who remember? What did he find on the broken ship? We said that he found food and rum and guns and flour. And he took all of these things on the raft and keep them on the island because he will use these things. And then we said that he found a dog. What was its name? Who remember? Bull. Excellent. Who can describe bull? Who can describe bull? Bull is a small brown dog. Bull is a small brown dog with dark eyes and a very friendly face. So again, Bull is a small brown dog with a dark eye, with dark eyes and a very friendly face. And he called him Bull. And then we said that Robinson was eating from his garden. He made a garden and he planted vegetables and fruit, and he was eating them on the island. But he still has a problem. What was it? He still has a problem. What is it? That he is alone. Now he can have food, and he can have a house or a small room to live in. But he didn't have any people. He didn't have any man to speak him. He missed his family very much. And then we said that he took from the ship what? Her papers and pen. And what did he write? He wrote a diary. He wrote a diary. What's meaning of diary? Diary means things happen to you every day, like your daily. You know the daily? You write every day. The teacher tells you to open your daily and write today's homework. To write what happened to you today. What did you take today? So this is a diary like a daily. Robinson used this diary to write the things that happened to you every day. And it helped him to remember the day and to remember his thoughts. Thoughts means ideas. And do you remember last time we said that what did he write in his diary? The last thing that he wrote on his diary was that he was very sick. He was very sick. He was having a fever. He was having a fever. Now I want all of you to open your story, chapter 4, and let's start our story. Okay, I want all of you to open this picture. Open it in your story book, chapter 4. Okay, the title of our chapter is A New Friend. Who is the new friend? Who is the new friend? Yes, it's the parrot. In this chapter, Robinson found a parrot. Okay, it was, who can describe this parrot? The parrot is a small and green with yellow feather on top of its head. So a small parrot with green and yellow feathers on top of its head. And now Robinson has two friends, and he is better now. He doesn't feel lonely like at the beginning of the story. Now he has a dog and he has a parrot. And all of you know that the parrot can talk. The parrot can talk. So Robinson helped the parrot to talk. How did Robinson have a conversation with parrot? Conversation means talking. How Robinson made the parrot talk? Every day he tried to teach him a new word. Every day he tell him a word. Like for example a bread. So every day he takes a piece of bread and tell the parrot, this is a bread. This is every day. And after many years, they can have a conversation or a dialogue. They can talk. So again, every day he teach. Every day he teaches him a new word. And after many years, now they can speak. He can tell him, "What do we have for breakfast for today? Huh? Where is Paul?" And he can answer him. He tells him, "Paul is in the garden, and we can have bread. We can have bread for breakfast." So after many years, they have a conversation, and Robinson was no more lonely, but he still wants people or person to speak to him. You cannot live with animals all the time. You cannot live with animals all the time. You need people to speak with them. And again, we said that this is his tent, and he made it from the sail of the broken ship, and this is his garden. He started to plant this garden in February. Again, he started to throw the seeds and he began to plant his garden in February. Why? Because after February, March and April, and these are rainy seasons. Again, Robinson started planting his garden in February, because in March and April they are the rainy season. It rains in March and April, and rain helps the plants to grow. And we said that he was happy now with the parrot and the dog, but he wanted to see people. So he made a small boat, and he tried to leave the island, but he couldn't. Why? Because the sea was very dangerous. And one day he was walking around the island. He saw something very strange. He saw footprints. What's meaning of footprints? Footprints like this. This is footprints. I will show it to you. Here. This is footprint. Can you see it? So these are footprints. So again, Robinson was walking around. He was walking around the island, and he saw footprints, and he was very afraid, because he didn't know if these footprints are friendly or not. Are they bad people or good people? And this you will know at the next chapter, chapter 5, inshallah. Now I want all of you to open your chapter from the beginning. Chapter 4, a new friend. Again, who is a new friend? The parrot. The new friend is the parrot. Okay, I want all of you to hold your highlighter. I didn't die that day in 1660. We said that in his diary, in his daily, he wrote that I am very sick. And we said that he had a fever. But I felt very different about life after that. After he recovered, after he is okay, he saw that the life is a gift. Gift means something very special, something very good. We must keep our life. It's easy to die on an island. Why? Why it's easy to die on an island? Who knows? Because you are alone. There are no parents to help you. There are no hospital. There are no doctors to help you. And there is no medicine. So it's easy to die on an island. Why? When you are alone, because you are alone, there is no medicine. Medicine means cure. When you are sick, you take a medicine to be okay, to feel well. You take a medicine. So there is no medicine, there is no one to help you. There is no one to help you. So it's easy to die on an island when you are alone. There is no medicine, there is no one to help you. I learned new things all the time. Huh? What are the things that he learned? Huh? We said that he was fishing and he was planting garden. He was planting vegetable and fruit. He knew that the best month to start my vegetable garden was in February. Why? We said that after February, we have March and April, and they are rainy seasons. There are a lot of rains in March and April, and rains help plants to grow. So my vegetable garden, the best months to start my vegetable garden was in February because it rained in March and April. And he made plates. Plates means dishes. You eat in a dish, in a plate. And cups from wood or from coconut shells. This is a coconut shell. After he eat this white things, he keep the shell and make it as a plate. He put his food here and eat. So he eat in a plates and cups made from wood or coconut shells. And these are coconut shells. I felt like I was the only man on this earth. He was very lonely. And I had to learn everything by myself. The vexed problem was that I wanted to talk to someone. Then something wonderful happened. What was it? Huh? Who remember? He need to talk to someone. Huh? Who is the new friend? The parrot. And he will talk to him. He will teach him how to talk. And this is something wonderful happened. Wonderful means very exciting. Bull and I went for a walk one day through the forest. I heard a bird flying around my head, and I saw that it was a parrot, a small green parrot with yellow fur. A small green parrot with yellow feathers on top of its head. So describe the parrot. Again, a small green parrot with yellow feathers on top of its head. He said hello. He can speak hello, hello. It talks. So he can repeat the same word. Robinson said hello. The parrot said hello too. Robinson said it talks. He said it talks. The little bird made me laugh. Laugh means happy. And I was so happy to have a new friend. So this is the title of our chapter, a new friend, which is the parrot. Every day I try to teach it a new word. So how could Robinson make the parrot talk? Every day he teaches him a new word. And after several years, several means many. After several years, we could almost have a dialogue. A dialogue means speaking. We can speak to each other. So he tried to teach it a new word every day. And after many years, we could almost have a dialogue. We can speak together. So I came back to our tent in the morning after a swim in the sea, and we had a conversations like this. What should we have for breakfast? So he can speak to the parrot, and the parrot will answer him. Fruit and milk. So hey, comment here. Who said this? What should we have for breakfast? Who knows? What's meaning of comment? Comment means to tell me who said this sentence, who said this, and to whom, and where, and why. So what should we have for breakfast? Who said this? Robinson said this to the parrot on the island. after after a swam in the sea, because he wanted to speak to the parrot. And what do you want for breakfast? He asked him, what do you want to eat? He said, nuts. You see, Bull, he knows what he wants. Stupid Bull, who said this? The parrot. Bull barked. What's meaning of barked? Barked is the sound of the dog. Barked means the sound of the dog. And here, this is a picture here. The dog is barking. Say how how. This is the sound of the dog barking. So when the parrot said stupid bull, stupid means a bad word, you are bad. Bull barked, he was very angry. Bull barked when the bird said this. I didn't want to teach him that, but he heard me say it and he remembered it. So he didn't want to teach the parrot this bad word, stupid. But he heard him say it and he remembered it and said, I talked to Bull and the parrot like they were people. It made me feel very good. But there was still something missing. Something he can't found. Missing means can't found. He is not very, very happy. I still wanted to see another person. He need a man like him. He needs people. He needs his family. You cannot live with animals forever. It's very hard life. Then he made a small boat from a tree, but the sea was too dangerous. So I stayed close to the island. What's the meaning of stayed? Stayed to be in the same place and not leave. Stay means to be in the same place and not leave. He stayed close to the island. So again, he made a small boat from a tree, but the sea was too dangerous. So why he didn't sail by this boat? Why he didn't leave this island by this small boat? Because the sea was too dangerous and he stayed close to the island. The island I was on was large. Large means big. I found many new beaches and many new kinds of fruits with the boat. And that's when I saw the footprints. Again, what's meaning of footprints? I told you. A mark made by a foot or shoe. A mark made by a foot or shoe. And this is the picture I showed you. Okay, these are footprints. Repeat after me. Footprints. So while Robinson was walking on the island, he saw footprints of human being, of a person. And he was very afraid because he didn't know that these footprints are friendly or not. And that's when I saw footprints. So while he was walking on the island, he saw footprints. Someone else was on this island. He knew that there are people live on this island, but I didn't know if they were friendly or not. He didn't know whether these footprints are friendly or not. Are they good for good people or bad people? And we will know inshallah next chapter. I want all of you to open your story booklet, chapter 4. Okay, we said several means more than a few, but not a lot. Many. Several means many. Bark is the sound of the dog. Here, the dog is barking. Stay means to be at the same place and not leave it. footprint, we said that this is footprint. Why was it easy to die on an island, on the island, huh? We said it, why? Because there was no medicine and there was no one to help you. How did Robinson know that there was someone else on the island? How did he know that there was someone else there, that there was a man on the island? He saw footprints on the island. While he was walking, he saw footprints on the land. Write about Robinson's new friends. The first friend is Ball. He's a small brown dog with dark eyes and a very friendly face. The parrot is small and green with yellow feathers on top of its head. They made Robinson feel very good. What should we have for breakfast? Do you remember who said this? Robinson said this to the parrot in the tent in the morning when they had a conversation together. Conversation means speaking. When they were speaking together. This is your homework. After you listen to the CD of the story, and after you read the story, answer this question. Please listen to the CD and read the story many times. Why did Robinson start his vegetable garden in February? What did I tell you? What comes after February? We said March and April. And what happens in March and April? And why it's useful to the planting? Okay, question two. Did Robinson use his small boat to leave the island? Did he leave the island? Why? Describe the sea. How was the sea? Robinson learned new all the time. Question two. It felt like Robinson was the only on this earth and he had to learn everything by... Number three, the vexed was that he wanted to do someone. And thank you for listening.